Good morning, students. Today, once again moving ahead for class 11th economics, we were discussing microeconomics. Student, we have started with the microeconomics chapter 1, that is economics and economy. You can go through that part. But before moving on further, I will explain you few of the things that we have discussed prior. The first thing that we discussed was what is economics. Other than that, how the choice occurs, what is the problem of choice and how it pertains into the three forms like consumer's point of view, your producer's point of view and how it is in their government. Other than that, we have also discussed your difference between microeconomics and macroeconomics. Now, next we will move further. Today we will study, first is approaches of economics. Students, everybody has its own approach, right? When sometimes you find a person to be very positive, it's his approach to see the life, it's his approach to see the things. Sometimes a person is always backed by a reason, it's his approach. So similarly, in economics, the approaches are divided into positive and normative. First, we'll take positive. Students, positive economics says it deals with the issues related to past, present or future. That means it has to be backed by few of the facts that could be related to past, present or future. Whatever a statement is there must be verified. It can be verified and backed by the truth. Nothing, no of the statement that doesn't has any kind of facts or figure cannot be considered as a positive economics. Understood? Moving ahead, what one thing that comes into the mind for is that it clears what was, what is and what would be. Understood? If I say that in 2021, the population census would be dead. That is a statement that has its point. Alright, backed by the figure. For example, 22% of population is absolute poor. That statistics must be mentioned, would have been mentioned some or the other way. That can be verified. That means truth should be there. So few of the characteristics of positive economics are like, it deals with economic issues that have facts and figures. It can be verifiable and most importantly, it does not reflect any value judgment. It does not support any opinion. It does not support any kind of debates or any kind of conflicts. What is there, it is there. That can be seen. Understood? Similarly, moving ahead, another is your normative economics. Students, normative economics is just the opposite of your positive one. How? As positive deals with the issues related to past, present or future, it depends on what ought to be. What ought to be? A possibility. It may not be. It is not backed by any kind of figure. Any of the scheme that is run by the government, for example, MNREGA, that is run by the government to remove unemployment. I say that in coming few years that would remove unemployment. But how many years? Don't know. No certain figure is mentioned anywhere. So this can pertain into opinions, that can pertain into judgments, that can pertain into conflicts and debates also. So here it becomes clear that normative economics deals with what ought to be, deals with the opinions. It involves value judgments, judgmentals. Everybody has its own value. It's given to the discussion point. It cannot be verified. You cannot verify anybody's opinion or you can never count on it. There is no right or wrong in it. Everybody is right on its part. Other than that, so it leads to controversies and debate. If everybody means you can say, not accepting a point, then definitely debate occurs. And lastly, opinions are framed. So these were few of the mix of normative economics. And for example, as I discussed, MG Narega will one day bring an end to the problem of unemployment. That's true, because an unemployment scheme is there. But when? We can't say that. Understood? Now, next point is your types of economies. How and how many types of economies are there? Students, our country, like we are living, we are having our own economic activities to run our families. Similarly, various economic activities are there in the whole of the country. And when all that decisions are taken by the government, it is considered as the economic activities of the country. Investment, how to invest, when to invest, for how much to investment is done, and various other decisions they are taken by the government. Now, what types of economies are there? First is your centrally planned economy, market economy, and mixed economy. Centrally planned economy is also called as controlled economy. Controlled economy. How? That I'll explain in detail now. Centrally planned economy, very first point is economic activities are controlled by government. Controlled by government means the government is the sole authority to decide everything. To decide where to invest, how to invest, or what to produce, what not to produce, what price and what not, everything is controlled by government only. No intervention of anyone. Keeping, why is it so? Because government has its own point, motive of social welfare. Government says that all the sections of the society should have equal rights. Poor should not be poorer or richer should not get richer. Everybody should have the same authority of purchasing the things. Other than that, consumer is not sovereign. There is no intervention of the consumer. Consumer cannot decide anything. Consumer has no choice. Whatever is there in the market, at that price, consumer has to purchase it. Other than that, resources are controlled by the government. It is government who controls the resources means. Alright? And if you are not wrong, then if you see, then public sector is the best example of it. Railways. Do we intervene in between? The tickets, the fares of the tickets are similar for both the sections, private, for us also and for everybody. Alright. So that is centrally planned or controlled government, controlled by the government economy. Next is your market economy. See, market economy is first thing is run for the profit maximization. The producers will produce those things only to which they'll find that profit is there. Prices are set accordingly. If you have capability to purchase it or not. So economic activities are controlled by market forces. Consumer is sovereign. Consumer has many choices. If it is backed by the money, you can purchase. If not, then no. Then most resources are controlled by the people because it is backed by the profit maximization like it occurs in private sector. Understood? Next is your mixed economy. Economic activities are controlled both by market forces and by government. This kind of economy is run in our country as few of the benefits are for the poor section and for a richer section also prevails. So, both social and profit maximization side by side goes parallel. Other than that, consumer is sovereign. Consumer has full choices. But PDS systems, minimum support prices, etc. are also there for poorer section. So that they can also avail the things. Ration shops are there. You must have studied in class 10. Both the things are there in. That is, most of the resources, or you can say intervention of government and the public, both are there. That is why it is known as public-private sector. So students, today we have learned few of the approaches of economics. Then we have discussed about positive, normative. Other than that, we have discussed centrally planned, market economy and mixed economy. That's all for today. Next video, we'll move on to the next chapter. Till now, thank you.